to CMT Southern Fried Flicks. I am your host, Hazel Smith. Beautiful, young, and sexy. Who is that ringing my bell? Oh, Lord. It's my dearest friend on earth. It's the beautiful Allison Krauss. Honey, we need some breakfast, don't we?
We do.
That's what we like to do is have coffee and sausage and eggs, don't we?
That's right.
And biscuits. I've got meatloaf for you, and I've got fresh green beans with new potatoes. I've got corn macaroni baked, and then I have got hazel cake.
That's what I'm talking about.
So you have to take some. That's the same. You have to take some home with you.
I'll do it.
Okay, you get Billy to fix you some.
Billy?
We'll get to eating in just a minute, but first let's get back to the movie. Welcome back to CMT Southern Fried Flicks. I'm your host, Hazel Smith, and this is the beautiful Allison Krauss, who's my dear friend, one I love dearly. And we've got meatloaf, green beans with new potatoes, and corn and macaroni bake. Start anywhere you want to, Allison. I think I'm going to start with meatloaf, because I tell you, this is Sunday meatloaf. You know, company's coming, meatloaf. So how was it to get back with the band? Y'all have been doing your own thing a little bit. You went out for a couple of years with Robert Plant.
Yeah, everybody's been kind of going their separate ways, and mm-hmm. we came back together, and it's just been great.
It's like they never left.
It's like the leaving made it better.
Sweet, uh-huh.
I don't know.
I think you're saying it well, and that's probably what happened. Sometimes absence makes the heart grow fonder.
That's correct.
Exactly. And of course, Allison, you brought a real special guest today. I did not know he was coming. So honored am I to have the great Dan Tominski in my kitchen. Isn't that something? Look at him.
Hello. Thank you for having me come.
Oh, I'm glad you came.
Oh, are you kidding me? I can smell the food from outside. It's killing me. I can't stand it.
Hey, Billy, can you fix Dan Tominski a plate, son?
Oh, you gotta be kidding. Here he is right there.
Oh, what I have to put up with. The things I have to put up with.
I know, and this Allison album, I tell you what. What do y'all think about it? I think you got a great album out there, Hillbilly Girl.
Oh, we're glad it's over.
I'm sure, yeah.
We're glad we finally finished it. We thought it was never gonna happen.
Uh-huh.
And finally we got it done. That's how I see it now.
Were you too hard to please or what, honey?
You're very particular.
Oh, is that what it is? Dan, we'll get back to you. Of course, Allison, we're going to talk some more about that album. But right now, we got to get back to the movie. I know that y'all had problems trying to finish up your album. And then I seen someplace where you just finally went to Robert Lee Castleman and said, you're going to write me a song, didn't you?
Well, I just called to see if he would write something, but he wasn't feeling well.
And you went out there and all he gave you was toasted cheese sandwich.
Well, my contribution was making grilled cheese sandwiches that he didn't even eat. I just made them for myself. And then we got a beautiful song. He wrote the title song.
And that is?
Paper Airplane.
Very good song. You like it, don't you?
I love it, yeah.
Do you like it, Dan?
I do. I love it.
Mm-hmm. Well, all right. Okay.
If you were in prison, Hazel,
yeah,
what would you be there for?
Overeating problem. And,
I thought it would be like fighting people off that want to come after your food.
Yeah.
That just can't stand it. Then you can't take it, so you fight them, and then you have to go to jail.
He knows, but you don't know. You know who used to come to my house and eat all the time?
I don't.
Bill Monroe.
Well, he's a smart man. He just went up a notch in my book.
Oh, no, I got to think about it.
If you was in women's prison, what would you be there for, Allison?
Well, that's a tough question. There's so many choices. Breaking and entering, I think.
Yeah.
Like here to get the food?
Maybe.
For some Sister Schubert's rolls.
Oh, yeah, that's what we put a sausage on, Sister Schubert's rolls. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about something about the album, about some of the favorite cuts. You know, just tell me which ones are the good cuts and how many songs you got on there, Allison?
We have 11 songs on there, but I really want to know if Dan was in women's prison. If you were in women's prison, why would you be in the women's prison?
Why would I? It would purely be for visitation. That would be it. Be visitation because you're obviously going to end up there. You need someone to come say hey. So that's why I would go.
Well, do tell me this, Dan. What's your favorite cut on that album?
I have to say, if it were my choice for the album, I like Dimming of the Day. It's the song that probably touches me the most. I've listened to it over and over and over again. Mm-hmm. So many times. More times than I think I've listened to anything else that we've recorded. You can imagine.
Ever?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Have you got a website?
We do.
Can they go to your website and order your album?
I think so.
You can. You can order the album and you can get a little preview of the tracks. You can listen to some
really?
Of the stuff while there's a little video footage. Yeah.
And that is to AllisonGrass.com. Is that right? See there? What we found that? Ain't that smart of me? Are y'all ready for some dessert?
Yes.
Would that be more green
well,
beans?
Only after I finish the rest of
it. Yeah, I know it. I can't. I will be ready, but I can't let any of this go. This has to stay with me. I love it.
Like this.
We don't finish this off, but we got to get you folks back to the movie. Welcome one more time to CNT Southern Fried Flicks. I am here with Allison, my dear sweet friend Allison Krauss and her bandmate Dan Tabinski, who swears he's never eaten food this good
in my life.
We're now going into some cake here.
So you made us wait for the cake. I can't stand it.
He couldn't stand it.
I took a little bite before we started. Mm-hmm.
What is going on in here?
In the cake?
Yeah.
Oh, we just. You know, listen, I had to make it so fast, I hope it's good. You people out there, y'all do recognize the great Dan Tabinski. He's a member of Union Station. He is the man that sang, did a marvelous job singing Man of Constant Sorrow in that unbelievable movie, Oh Brother. And I was so proud of him. And I mean, after that was over, every time he'd go out, people would want him to sing, wouldn't they, Alice?
They love it.
They still request it, don't they?
They love it.
Mm-hmm. I am the man of constant sorrow. I've seen trouble.
Allison, don't you want this right here? Because it's got coconut and content. I don't believe you got none.
Oh,
like
no,
this.
I did. That's what I was wondering what was going on down there. It was
okay.
This right here.
If you want some more of it, maybe I'll get it for you. I
think
know.
That'd be best.
While Boo was getting you some more cake, I do want to thank you for stopping by and you.
Oh, thank you so
and
much.
And tell you how much I love you and thank y'all for coming. It's just been a real treat.
Love you too.
It's hardly ever you have real people in your kitchen, but I sure got them right now, haven't I?
Too even real.
Then, but let me tell you something. Any of y'all that missed seeing Allison Krauss in Union Station, you have missed the biggest treat you could ever have in your life. I wouldn't miss it for anything. Before we get you back to the conclusion of Three Amigos, I just want to thank my friend, Allison Krauss, for stopping by. I love, love, love her. Of course, thank y'all for watching as well. I will see you next time on CMT Southern Fried Flicks. Now let's get back to the movie.